I only use the Authorized King James Version, except, of course, if you preach in Dutch, the NBG 1951 is a good translation. It's not a version. It's almost the same as the King James, because it's just a translation, and it didn't fix anything. So there are two reasons for this thing. There are two reasons why there are so many Bibles. The first is very obvious. Yea, had God said? Questioning God's word. God said, this is my word, and the devil says, is that true? Well, I make my own version. That's the first one. That's the first reason. And he twists this thing. But the second reason is the love of money. The love of money is the root of all evil. If you want to copy something, like a movie or a book or a song, according to the law, you have to change it 10 or 20% to make it your own version. Some people say, yeah, it's not true anymore. The judge has to decide. But anyway, one of the two, you have to change it enough to make it your own version. That means that if you want to put out a King James version, because this is free. King James is copyright free. You can copy this for free. But if you want to make money on this one, you have to change it 10 or 20% so that the judge can say, yes, this is different enough to make it your own version, and then you can make money. The Bible still is the most sold book in the world. You don't see that in the news, but the Bible is still number one seller in the world. Can you imagine? But of course, the devil don't want to put that in the mainstream. He only wants to put his garbage in the mainstream. This is the first number one sold book, so that's very good news, of course. We can see, if somebody wants to change it, there's a warning. Go to the last page. This is Revelation 22, 18. The last page, we went from the first page to the last page. And God says, okay, you want to change it? It's okay, you can do that, but know that there are consequences. It says in Revelation 22, 18. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book, if any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. That's a clear warning, right? And it says, and if any man shall take away from the words of this book, of this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life and out of the holy city and from the things which are written in this book. I mean, this is a very good warning, right? And now you have a decision. Do you really want that money bad? The love of money is the root of all evil. Twisting the Bible is evil. It's very evil. So do you really want that money for this lifetime? Because your name is going to get out of the book of life. It's a clear warning. Don't mess with this word. Don't mess with this.